So in this video we are going to see a recruitment from Indian Navy. So there is a recruitment happening from Indian Navy, and if you have BTech qualification in any branch with a 60% of mark, or if you have MBA qualification or MSc or MA, then you are eligible. Okay, so if you are having any of these qualifications, please to watch this video till the end. We are going to see all details in this video, the post details, the application procedure, selection procedure, qualification, everything we'll be seeing in this video. Okay, so first let us see the post details. So before seeing the post, so this recruitment is actually they are conducting for a course which is going to start on June 2021 onwards, and after you complete this course you'll be appointed as permanent. Okay, so that is how the recruitment is actually going to happen. Initially they'll be conducting a course for the selected people, and after the course you will be appointed for various branches. Okay, so that is how the recruitment is going to happen. And there are three categories, there is three major categories for which recruitment is happening. First one is executive branch, then there is technical branch, and then there is education branch. And for some recruitments or for some category they are only recruiting men, for some category they are recruiting men and women. Okay, so that is how the recruitment is going to happen. And also let us see the qualification details. For executive branch, if you have a B or BTech in any discipline, if you see the entire list, there is actually various categories coming under this executive branch itself. But mainly, if you have a B, BTech in any discipline that may be, metallurgical, chemical, electrical, electronics, mechanical, automobile, microelectronics, instrumentation, electronics and instrumentation, electronics and telecommunication, all the branches are eligible. Okay, so that is the qualification for executive branch. And it is having also a lot of openings. Okay, and if you see the age limit, it is mainly from, it is for the people who is born in between July 1996 to January 2002. Okay, that is July 1996 to January 2002 is the age limit for the executive branch. Okay, next is technical branch. Also you can see the detail notification on the screen now. Can see that for whichever category they are recruiting. Okay, anyway, the qualification is B, BTech, and also you should be having 60% of mark. Okay, for your B, BTech you should be having 60% of mark. Next is for the technical branch. Again, for technical branch there are actually two categories of technical branch they are recruiting: SSC engineering branch and SSC electrical branch. Again, if you have a B, BTech in any discipline you are eligible, but you should be having a 60% of mark. Okay, so the SSC engineering branch is having 30 openings, and SSC electrical branch is having 40 openings. And also for this technical branch only male candidates can apply. Okay, age limit is from July 1996 to, that is if you are born in between July 1996 and January 2002, only then you are eligible. Okay, they have actually given the specific cutoff dates. Okay, for the age limit. Next is for education branch. There is only one category of recruitment happening under the education branch, and it is SSC education. Qualifications that are eligible are first class MSc, chemistry, physics, maths, all the branches are eligible. Then if you have 55% in MA English, or if you have 55% in MA history, again you are eligible. Here also BTech candidates can apply. Electronics and communication, electrical, electronics, electronics and instrumentation, all the branches can apply. Okay, mainly electronics branch specifically. They are eligible for all categories of recruitments actually. For the executive branch, technical branch and for education branch, the electronics branch is eligible. Okay, again, for the SSC education or the education branch recruitments, both men and women candidates can apply. Okay, so that is the qualification details and age limit. Now let us see the application procedure. So for applying, you have to apply online. You have to go to joinindiannavy.gov.in, then apply online. Okay, so you can actually apply from 18th of December, and the last date of application is 31st of December. Okay, so the 31st of December or towards the end of December there is time, and you can apply from 18th of December. Okay, so that is the application procedure. You have to fill up all the details, education qualification, photo, your you have to actually keep these things in your hand ready before applying. Your birth proof, your qualification certificates, all the things, ID proof, everything you have to keep with yourself. Okay, then you have to apply online. Next is the selection procedure. So you know that for Indian Navy and these type of recruitment, there will be SSB selection process happening. So it is consisting of the initial shortlisting for SSB. Then there will be SSB procedure happening or SSB stages. There are various stages of SSB selection process will be there. Then there will be medical examination. And finally, the merit list will be made by combining this SSB and the medical examination. Okay. So that is the selection process. So we'll be doing also a separate video on the selection process of this Indian Navy recruitment. So if you are interested, please do mention in the comment section. Okay. We'll be doing us a separate video. And we'll be discussing what all things are going to happen in SSB, what is the syllabus, what is the exam pattern, everything we are going to see in this way, in that video. Okay. So that is the selection process. And also they have mentioned the training duration for the officers, that is for the executive branch, there will be a training of 44 weeks. And for the all other branches excluding IT, there will be a training of 22 weeks. Okay. So there is actually a training period. After the training period or after completing the course only, you are going to appoint it as a permanent job. Okay. And also there is a probation period of 2 to 3 years also. Okay. After the training, there is also some probation period. So this is just like any other Indian Navy recruitment itself. Okay. So that's all about the recruitment news from Indian Navy. There's actually a lot of openings for male and female candidates and for all the branches of engineering. Okay. So if you are interested, please do see the notification first in detail. Actually, if you talk about the electronics branch specifically, they are actually eligible for all the categories of recruitments. Okay. So that is the application procedure and selection procedure and everything. So there is no fees for applying. So you can always try your luck. Okay. So please do apply for it. And also another important thing, which I forgot to mention, that finalists are also eligible. Okay. So anyway, you'll be seeing that on the thumbnail, but I want to mention that here that it is also eligible for finalists. Okay. So for the case of finalists, you have to take the percentage till your 7th semester. Okay. And you have to upload the certificates for that till that 7th semester. And you have to calculate the CGPA according to that. Okay. Anyway, they have mentioned everything, that is what is the case for finalists, how to calculate the CGPA, what all things you have to upload, everything they have mentioned in the notification. Okay. Anyway, I want to tell you that finalists are also eligible for all the branches of electronics and also for all engineering branches generally. Okay. So please do see the notification. If you think that you are eligible, please do apply for it as soon as possible. The last date is 31st of December. Don't wait till that. Please do apply for it as soon as possible. Okay. So I'm really hoping that you found the video useful. If yes, please do give it a thumbs up. Please do share it with your friends. If you want more videos, please do subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching and keep on watching.